Welcome back to KTLA 5 Live. This year, KCET is celebrating the 25th anniversary of the iconic TV show, Visiting with Huell Howser. Huell loved California. He was a journalist who never made the story about himself, but rather the people he was talking to and the sometimes very unique places he went. But there are so many of those episodes that haven't been seen in years. So today there's a Kickstarter to get them digital and streaming. And we're so excited to talk to Corbett Barklie, the head of development at KCET. Corbett, thank you so much for joining us.
Well, thank you for having me.
I personally love Huell Howser. I
think Me personally too.
A wonderful human being, and that came through in his storytelling. But what is this Kickstarter campaign all about?
Well, so Huell has a vault of tapes. And there's hundreds of tapes. They're at Chapman University.
Go Panthers.
And those tapes over time can begin to disintegrate. Mm-hmm. And so we are saving the tapes, saving Huell's legacies by getting those tapes and digitizing them, also updating them by closed captioning them all and reformatting them so that they can go on to streaming platforms like Roku and Amazon, and et cetera. And we want to preserve his legacy. We know that Huell appeals to many generations. Generations above mine, mm-hmm. generations, my generation, your generation. It's really amazing that he is able to connect with so many people, mostly because, as you say, it's always about people other than himself. Mm-hmm. He filmed things very simply, and we're so happy to be celebrating 25 years of visiting with Huell Howser. In 1993, KCET joined forces with Huell to co-produce Visiting. And that partnership lasted until 2011. So yeah, as you can imagine, there are hundreds and hundreds of episodes. Many haven't been seen in a long time.
And Natalie, you mentioned just getting the transition from your family tapes onto digital and DVD is quite a process. And
it
it's
really
not
is.
Cheap. So that's why you guys have a Kickstarter, reaching out to people in the community.
And what is your goal for this? How much money do you need to raise? How much have you had? How do people get there so they can immediately, you know, go and help you guys out?
Our Kickstarter is $25,000. Okay. We're doing great. We have 10 days left. 10 days left.
Scott, we have it on the surface if you want to bring that up.
And we're at 60%. There it is there. And we're doing great. Over 200 people have participated in this, so there aren't a bunch of, you know, it's just a small amount of big donors. This is a lot of people that are joining in. And the excitement about Huell is really quite amazing. It never seems to ebb. It's consistent.
He really is timeless.
So he really is.
This is the first thought that came to my mind when I was kind of doing all of this was, who owns the rights to all Huell's stuff? Did he sign it over so that it would be public domain? Like, how did this kind of all come to be?
Well, his archive is with Chapman University.
Uh-huh.
So they hold the archive. We have broadcasting rights for visiting with Huell Howser and also for California's gold.
Right.
So it's been taken care of that way. It's not in the public domain.
I got it.
And we're so proud that we're the ones that can broadcast it.
Absolutely. Scott, we have a little teaser video if we want to show people at home exactly what they're looking for with this Kickstarter campaign to get Huell digitized.
Nobody loved California quite like Huell Howser. The big vistas, the hidden gems, the offbeat people who always turned out to have a story you didn't expect.
What have I got myself into?
And that's why California loved him.
Huell Howser!
Hey!
He produced over 1,000 programs during his time at KCET, and Huell fans have been clamoring to see more of his early episodes, both on air and online. But those old tapes are stuck waiting in the archives, waiting for someone to digitally convert them. And that's where you come in. We've created this Kickstarter campaign to get that done. We've handpicked the best rare and vintage episodes of Visiting from Huell's archives.
Wow!
When you pledge, your money goes to digitizing these old tapes for broadcast on KCET and for streaming on platforms like Amazon, Roku, and Apple TV. And don't forget to check out our amazing rewards. Most of all, though, you'll be a part of Huell's legacy just by helping to preserve these classic shows now and for generations to come. And that will be truly amazing.
And for people wondering where the money goes, we have either a video, Scott, or it's on the surface either way, because people might be wondering, how is $25,000 really the cost of getting all these onto a digital platform? It's not cheap.
And there's some manpower involved. Someone will get in their car and drive to Chapman, pick up a bunch of tapes, bring them back to our studios in Burbank. Then they'll be digitized. Then they'll be closed captioned. And then they'll be updated for platform consumption so people can stream them.
And this is obviously something that is really important to you, but all fans here, what was your favorite place or favorite episode that he ever did?
That's a hard question.
That's a hard question because I have a lot of them.
Go ahead. That's what we're here for. Hitting the hard questions.
Top five works. Top five.
So I'll tell you the last one because we were talking about it just yesterday was his at Pink's. I love the restaurant shows that he goes to. In fact, we have, after Labor Day, we have a whole week of doing just restaurant, Huell, and food. So I enjoy his food things. I also enjoy just the quirky people that he met in all sorts of places. And just in watching that promo, I was reminded about how he really is the storyteller of our region. And he, in this time of some confusion and chaos in general in our lives, it is so wonderful to know that Huell Howser exists. He'll tell a story simply. He'll be amazed by it. He'll find joy in it, the joy of discovery. And life is pretty simple and wonderful.
You know, we have a piece of that Pink's episode that's just playing on my surface, if you want to take that at some point, just for a little background on his editing.
I was going to say, one of the cool things that kind of came up when we were talking about this was I worked with the Epilepsy Foundation here in Los Angeles for a number of years, and one of our program directors actually just happened upon Huell back in the day and kind of told him his story, and the next thing you knew, there was an episode. So it kind of speaks to the approachability and kind of when you say the kind of characters he comes across, he also would interact with those characters and say, what's your story? Which is pretty cool.
Yeah, and I can confirm that that kind of excitement wasn't something that he just did on air. For a short period of time, I had an office right next to Huell's, and I can tell you that day in and day out, he was discovering something. He was meeting people that he thought were the most miraculous people he'd ever met, even more than the last person he met. And it was really quite amazing that that's just him, that's that guy.
I think Scott touched on it with approachability.
Yeah.
Because he could easily just walk up to somebody doing something that we would consider menial or routine and find it very interesting and find a way to tell that story. And you mentioned your favorite being Pink's. Huell is just the cutest man with his belt, and he was a Marine, so he still has those biceps in some of these older videos. I think that is just precious. So after you get all the Kickstarter campaign, very popular in Kickstarter campaign to have little rewards as the more you give, the more you give. And that's part of the overall budget, but it's only a couple thousand compared to 25. So what can people get by helping you?
Well, they get to be part of Huell's legacy.
Most importantly,
we want to share his legacy with everyone, and we feel that that's our responsibility, and it's our commitment, and it's our joy.
Tote bags, keychains.
Sure. There's no keychain.
Oh, no keychain.
No. I got caught up on your roll. There's tote bags, there's t-shirts.
Stop saying cool. There's keychains all the time.
Sorry.
Sam, there isn't always
keychains.
There isn't always a keychain, but there could be.
There's enamel pins, there's a very cool tie-dye t-shirt, and there are more rewards that are gonna be posted today.
Right.
We're doing pretty well, so for those who have already given, you'll be getting more than you thought, and for those who haven't, we hope that you'll join us.
You say the small things, and Sam, this is kind of, it's a question then for the group. Is there something that in recent years you've thought, oh man, if Huell were here, I would love to see his take on this. Is there anything that's kind of, my thought, to be honest with you, was the little, when the fidget spinners became a big thing, I'd just love to see him kind of get into how somebody invented them and where they came from. I just think that'd be cool.
Oh, he would have been all over those.
Yeah.
He would have been all over a new pencil or a new pen you know, anything. It was remarkable that anything could fascinate him.
You know, and there's a whole generation of kids and students now, Chapman, that haven't seen him or don't know about his legacy. Is this going to be then taken to those kids in school, helping with that journalism program or seeing how to tell a story
Well, we certainly hope that on streaming platforms, you know, kids will be able to access these more. But what we've also found is that families hand down the legacy of Huell by generation.
Got it from my mom.
My dentist, for example, talks nonstop from the moment I walk in to the moment I walk out about Huell and all of the things that he loved about Huell, and then he always talks about how his son is now watching Huell. Well,
and you've got to be like, I understand.
I just do the thumbs up. I do thumbs up a lot.
Thank you so much for coming in, Corbett. We appreciate it so much. If you want to get involved in the Huell Howser Kickstarter, you can go to kickstarter.com and search for Bring Back Huell's Greatest Hits. We are so thankful you were able to come in today.
And
like Natalie
mentioned,
this is going to be a great tool for all the kids who don't know Huell's greatness yet.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
We'll be right back on KTLA 5 Live.